Okay, we are hopping into Week 1 Premier Division Group A, Airlu versus Cactus. Let's get into it. All right, spawning in the bottom, in the yellow, we've got Cactus, and up top, in the top right, Airlu. So, immediately, I'm looking at Cactus's deck, and I'm a little bit excited because I see this Squirrel Toad turret. And I'm really curious how he's going to be able to handle the Squirrel Mole Cam from Airlu if Airlu decides to push out. I've always kind of seen Airlu as a player who really grasps timing windows and knows when to pull the trigger, when to get aggressive, when to macro up. So, you know, especially in this patch right now, the moles really, really accentuate opportunities to come in when you get a small tempo advantage from either an opponent doing something too greedy, or maybe you win a nice little skirmish. You can build some moles and just kind of end the game, or at least deal critical damage. A little bit of mole harass here from Airlu, but this is just a little back and forth thing. The turret's a nice little answer to this as well. We'll see how it goes forward from here. I'm mostly curious. One thing that I love the most about Tooth and Tail, and I was kind of thinking about this last night, actually, because I follow a lot of RTS games and watch a lot of the esports, and honestly, I feel like more scouting happens in Tooth and Tail than any other major RTS. You are constantly scouting back and forth in Tooth and Tail, and mind games can really be a big thing, so it's very important to think about, you know, not necessarily if Cactus has thrown down a fox, but has Airlu seen the fox, right? That's a very big part of this story here. So Airlu going for a quick expansion. I like this second base for Airlu a lot. Unfortunate for Cactus here, this map gen is pretty bad for him. You know, he's got this base down here on the low ground, but that's going to be very easy for Airlu to push into. So I'm curious how Cactus is going to approach this. I mean, Cactus does see the expansion coming up from Airlu. So right now he's moving out a little bit, and I'm so excited to see these Toads in a Premier game. I would love to kind of, for my own purposes, for my Tooth and Tail notepad, see how Toads perform against the Moles. Because again, I think right now the Moles are arguably one of the strongest units in the game. I don't know, I could start an argument in the chat with that kind of statement, but they're very strong units at the moment, so let's see. Cactus is just gonna blow up the mill with the Toads, and he gets it! Oh my god, sign my mousepad, Cactus. But he might have lost too many units here. Airlu is getting ready for the counterattack, and honestly, that was really cool and really hyped to cast, but was it a good move from Cactus here? Because Airlu only had one farm on that expansion. And Cactus really invested a lot of resources into getting that kill. But man, I was just happy for it because I always love watching Toads blow Chris Mills. It's the best thing in the world. So nice counterattack here from Airlu. And keep in mind that Cactus, like generally that kind of move is gonna propel you to win the game, but Cactus doesn't have his own natural. So by taking out Airlu's natural, you just put Airlu back on even footing. And then with Airlu's counterattack, he got a Warren, he got a Pig. So Airlu is in really strong shape right now. Cactus is scratching his head, trying to think what he can do. He's going to go for the cam. Airlu does scout that, but after Airlu scouted it, Cactus does sell it for some more tier 1. I think this makes sense, but let's see. Airlu moving forward again, and Airlu knows, again, as I was saying earlier, I think Airlu's superpower as a Tooth and Tail player is just really understanding when you've got the advantage, when you can push in and end the game, and Airlu knows that's exactly the situation he's in right now. He's not going to be overcommitting, he's not going to overextend, which is a good way to lose. Tooth and Tail engagements can be so crazy sometimes, you know, if the enemy units have the right terrain advantages, you know, if your units get too clumped up or spend too much time looking for tiles, I mean, you can really lose an engagement very, very hard. And Airlu just coming in, getting more and more damage done. Got the economy behind him. And Cactus, I don't blame this from Cactus. I don't see what else he could really do here. Maybe he could try to take a hidden expansion over to the west. Yeah, unfortunately, I mean, this kind of looks like checkmate for Airlu. Unfortunately, I guess, for Cactus. Fortunately for Airlu, right? And I think this game really comes back to Cactus's decision to hard target down that mill. And that follow-up counterattack from Heirloo. But let's see if Cactus can take a good fight here. Maybe he can crawl back into this game. So far, it's not looking bad for Cactus, but I think Heirloo's units, especially with the Defender's Advantage, should clean it up. I wouldn't be surprised to see Cactus tap right here. And there it is. Game number one, going over to Heirloo here. With Cactus maybe being a little bit over-eager, trying to take out that mill. And Heirloo understanding his advantage and cleaning up the match with it. I don't blame Cactus there, because again, I mean, the natural base map gen was just so hard for Cactus. He had to try to think of something to do. A little bit wild, Cactus in the bottom right here. Heirloo up in the top left. And this map looks a little better for both sides. You know, Heirloo does have a nice natural. Looks like one entrance into the main, which is good. And Cactus is in a similar situation. I mean, he's got two entrances, one through the way that Hopper just ran through. But mostly, I think Cactus can try to gear over here. And I mean, the third base for Cactus is a little bit easier, but I feel like this third base for Heirloo is fine if we get there. I mean, obviously, I'd rather be Cactus on this map gen, but hey, I think the most important thing with map gen is, okay, do both players have access to a nice natural base, which they do, so we can play a pretty standard game. Most games don't go past two bases anyways. I mean, maybe that's a little different in Premier League, because I think there's a lot more gentlemen's agreements in Premier League, where players can eco up to those 16 farms. But it seems like right now the meta really evolves around the Squirrel Mole Cam pushes. And a early game aggression, tier 1, tier 2 aggression. So I'm curious to see how Cactus approaches this game now that he's not really put into a corner from the map gen to feel like they've got to try to get something done. So far, 8 farm doubles from both sides. Cactus actually thrown down a third Warren. Heirloo did scout that. He's going to sell it. Okay, doesn't sell it for anything exciting. Was curious if he maybe sell it for a mill or a tier 2, but yeah, so far nothing too crazy just yet. Thanks everybody for tuning in, it's always fun. Tander Draco is going to be casting some more Premier League matches later today. I think he likes to cast around 6 p.m. CST, so definitely check those out as well if you're hungry for some more Tooth and Tail. And again, there are a ton of matches. Check out the video description or the links below to get access to the Discord. There are a lot of casters, there are a lot of divisions and players, so if you are a big fan of spectating Tooth and Tail, now is a great time for content. Alright, we got some cams coming up on both sides. Cactus playing a little safe with the turret, probably gonna sell that after he gets the scout. I think he was just worried he was going into a tier 2, and if Heirloo was just spamming that squirrel button, there might have been an opportunity to push in. But yeah, gonna go ahead and sell that turret now. Let's see what Heirloo ends up scouting. Double cam actually coming down for Cactus, but Heirloo is going double tier 2 as well. I'm not sure which is better. I mean, my gut reaction tells me I'd rather have double cam than cam Falcon for an early game engagement. But Falcons are pretty microbial units. If you get the right angles, if you can really take advantage of the burst and keep them protected, they can do a lot of damage. Heirloo is looking around for some Metal Gear Solid chameleons here, but gonna bring them home. It's always fun to play. It's always fun to try to get some value with some little esports micro moves. But you gotta be careful. I mean, if Heirloo loses these cams, that could be game. So he's looking for an opportunity, but he's being safe about it. Both players are starting to put some farms on the second base. And yeah, Heirloo is just going to go for more and more tier 2. Heirloo's kind of decided, okay, you know, you want to play macro, let's play macro. And Heirloo does have the wolf, so I feel like the late game army for Heirloo is going to be better. But I'm really curious to see how the toads perform if Cactus decides to build toads. I don't know. I think I've even seen it on this patch where you get enough toads and, I mean, you can just delete an army, so it, you really need the right engagement, all that kind of stuff. But imagine the toads like hitting all the cams from Heirloo if he masses cams with his wolf, and some of the squirrels. Ooh, Cam coming down here. Oh, I actually... Oh, I'm watching the instant replay on my stream. Okay, Erlu got two farms with those cams. So big advantage there for Erlu. That's 120 bucks for free. No tier 3 warrants coming out for either side just yet. Erlu thinking about moving out now, off of that little advantage. This is tough. Cactus will have the defender's advantage, but since Erlu does have the skunks, he's able to get some pre-gas going. So this might force Cactus to take the engagement. Cactus also trying to get into a lot of Falcons, but they're not on the board just yet. A turret coming up on the back here, but Erlu is moving forward, even going to build some Mole Warrens, and Erlu still has plenty of tier 2 left over. He's pushing in, and he might just have too much here. Cactus was trying to get into 6 Falcons, and Erlu hits just right before those are going to be ready. And the second base should be going down. There it is. And from there, Cactus knows that's GG. So taps out and puts Erlu up 2-0 this series. All right, let's see if Cactus can create a comeback here. A little bit of the underdog in this matchup, but would love to see him at least take a map or two off Erlu. In the bottom, we've got Erlu, and up top, Cactus. Cam Falcon, Squirrel from both sides. Again, I think the big wild card in these decks, I think Erlu's deck is very, very modern, very standard. Cactus with the turret and the toads, I think, are a little bit off meta. And the turret's in this weird spot right now, in my opinion, because, you know, the intended function of the turret is to, you know, kind of help you at the last minute, like, hold a big tier 1 attack. But since moles are so prevalent, and they do the structure crit, you know, the moles take care of the turrets pretty well. I think one of the players I was chatting with was saying, you know, if you get enough turrets, it can kind of deal with the moles, but... In like a throwing down one or two MGs situation, it doesn't seem worth it with the tankiness and crit damage of the moles, so. I still really want to see Cactus use these toads, use these MGs against that Squirrel Mole Cam this series, but we might not see it depending on how this game goes. I like this map a little better for Cactus. It's kind of an odd map, to be honest. I think Cactus has a good second base. And Erlu coming out here to the middle of the map with the second. I think that's fine. This base would be hard to take for Erlu, but we'll see how that goes a little bit later. Well, Sasha in the chat saying the turrets actually work pretty well against the moles. I want to see it. Like, I believe you, but I'd really love to see it. And I think we probably will as Premier moves forward. Yeah, I think Sasha's got a good point too about probably the tank. Like, you gotta have your units above, right? Like, you want to try to obviously keep the turrets in the back so they can DPS. That makes sense. All right, so a bunch of tier one from both sides. I wonder if Erlu doesn't like his nat. I don't know. I mean, I feel like this natural's fine, and then Erlu can actually. Now that I'm looking at this closer, I might like the gristmill placement for Erlu a little bit better. You know, these three bases seem a little bit nice. It's always nice when your expansions are moving away from your opponent. Some cams coming out from Erlu, but Cactus might be going for it. This is what I've been waiting for. Oh, these mines might be devastating, though. Good mine placement here. I don't think Cactus is hip to him. Takes one hit. Another hit. Those hits weren't too bad. The big engagement comes out. Are these toads gonna... Alright, some good toad connections, but it was not enough. That was a lot of toads going down right there, and Erlu still left over with a nice handful of squirrels, so Erlu's gonna push that back, no problem. And this looks tough for Cactus. I think he needed to get some damage there. Because Erlu is ahead on the tech. Is Cactus aware of that? Yeah, Cactus knows that tier 2 is on the way, and here's that big squirrel mole cam push from Erlu. And unfortunately, I think with that last engagement, we can't really you know, get out our notebooks on how these perform too much, because Airlu does have an advantage now, right? So this isn't just Squirrel Toad versus Squirrel Mole Cam, this is Squirrel Mole Cam having an advantage. Coming in. Cactus is trying to target the squirrel. Okay, those were some good Toad hits. But is it going to be enough? I don't think so. And Airlu is going to actually pull back for now. He wins that fight again, so that's two fights that Airlu has won. And what really hurt about that first fight for Cactus was that Airlu had a tier 2 on the way, right? So Cactus lost that engagement. Does get this mill, but again, trades a lot of resources for it. And I think if that... It was similar to game 1. You know, I do like the idea of targeting down the mill. Especially in moles or toads or something like that. But not a lot of inherent value off of that. Because there was only the one farm. You know, a little bit later on when there's 3, 4, 5 farms. I mean, that is devastating. But Airlu actually waiting for now. Not pushing in with the counterattack just yet. But this is just classic Airlu, just making sure everything's good. He got a nice deep scout. He knows there's nothing like a boar on the way or something like that. Are toads viable? Asked this guy in the chat. I think right now the short answer is no. But we'll see. I mean, can players make it work? I mean, just because something's not used in the meta, I don't know. That's hard to answer. I'm probably not the one with enough expertise to answer that, but I mean, sometimes there's sleeper units, right? I mean, sometimes something's not meta, and that doesn't necessarily mean it's not viable. It just means that people aren't doing that at the moment. But I feel like moles just kind of do what toads do better than them. So, nice, interesting approach from Airlu here. I thought he might just kind of go in and try to win the game, but he's going to be patient, just get ahead in economy, constantly scouting in, looking for any kind of tier 3, mostly, looking to see any big greed on tier 2, because those are really the only ways Airlu is going to lose this game right now. Oh, Cactus, what are you up to with these toads, brother? Oh, I got excited. I thought he was going to bring them on a mission. Alright, Cactus is gonna go in, and this is that value I was talking about. If he kills this mill, that's a little bit better, but he gets the mill at the cost of the entire army, though, and Airlu has an absolute unit moving forward. So he's gonna be very easily able to return the favor, and I think that's just going to be it. Cool concepts from Cactix. I liked what he's trying to do here. Maybe it would work if the map was a little bit bigger. But Airlu just rocking that Squirrel Mole Cam with some good game sense takes the series 3-0.